Sonakshi shows her Deva director the door. Salman is a victim of robbery. Varun and Kriti flirt. Is it a publicity stunt or something more? Shahrukh will not let the trolls win. Hey guys, I'm Caitlin and you have tuned in to 9xc.com, the show. I'm hot, you're not, I'm a superstar, I'm a superstar, 9xc. Things might just be looking up for Sonakshi Sinha on the professional front after the underwhelming performances of Deva and Action Jackson. She'll be seen in the A.R. Murugadose's action drama Akira and Apoorva Lakhia's film based on Dawood Ibrahim's sister, Haseena Parker. She's paired opposite John Abraham in the sequel to Force, and like 9xc.com exclusively told you, she'll star opposite Akshay Kumar in Namaste England as well. And looks like the Dabang star will not have her past interfere with her present to ensure her bright future. Sonakshi starred with Arjun Kapoor in the damp script Devar, helmed by director Amit Sharma. Seems Amit was under the impression that Devar was a misunderstood masterpiece because he went ahead and approached Sonakshi for another project. What Amit had to tell Sonakshi about the film is sure to blow your mind. Amit told her that this could be a career-defining film for her as it has been tailored to her strengths. And how did Sonakshi feel about this claim? Sonakshi has now made up her mind to take up projects which she's extremely sure of, even if that means saying no to a couple of filmmakers. So Sonakshi ne Amit ka project reject kar diya. Kya Amit ne woh kahawat nahi suni, once bitten, twice shy? Last heard, disheartened Amit is looking for alternate choices for his new project. And have you heard the latest on Sonakshi's friend turned foe turned friend Salman Khan? Salman is a pretty tough guy. He can beat up a bunch of baddies with a single punch, and at times only a look from him is enough to have his villains run in the opposite direction. But when it comes to dealing with the charms of women, looks like Salman's not such a tough guy after all.
You are too cute!
Reportedly, Salman has been a victim of a robbery. Salman and his crew were at a nightclub in Bandra in Mumbai. That's when four girls approached him, claiming to be fans. Salman politely chatted with one of them, and while that happened, the other three got to work. From Salman's table, they stole his wallet, sunglasses, and pendant. And no one caught on. By the time Salman and his security team realized that Salman's stuff had gone missing, it was too late. The girls had already left. Salman ko kaha gaya ki complaint file kare, lekin bhai nahi mane. Instead, Salman ne apni security team increase kar diye. Tell us your opinion on the story by tweeting to us at 9xc the show using hashtag Salman Khan robbed, or talk to us on facebook.com/9xc. And if you want more of the latest in Bollywood news, download the free 9xc app for your Android and iOS devices. Now from that story, let's look at what we have next on our radar. So the younger lot of Bollywood actors might swear by the friendships they've formed within the industry, but that does not mean that they won't indulge in some healthy competition. Varun Dhawan and Siddharth Malhotra debuted in Karan Johar's Student of the Year, and since then, both their careers have skyrocketed, with each working in big projects. And off-screen, they have a warm friendship going on too. But ye sab bonding baat ki baat ho jaati hai, lekin jab kaam ki baat aati hai... You know that Varun has backed out of Mohit Suri and Ekta Kapoor's project Half Girlfriend to do mentor Karan's production Shuddhi. But like we told you last episode, Shuddhi has been put on hold and Varun is working on another KJO production. So guess who is vying for his part of the Bihari boy in Half Girlfriend? It's none other than his dost and first co-star Siddharth Malhotra. Siddharth might be shooting for Bar Bar Dekho in Scotland, but all the way from there, he has been eyeing the role. And not just that, 9xc.com had told you that Katrina Kaif also wants to get her hands on the part in the film that was originally Alia Bhatt's. So if Mohit and Ekta agree to Siddharth and Katrina, the duo will work together once again after Baar Baar Dekho. Guess the younger lot know how to separate the professional and the personal lives. Tell us if you think that Siddharth will be a good choice for half-girlfriend. Feel free to tweet to us at 9xc the show using hashtag Siddharth in half-girlfriend or talk to us on facebook.com/9xc. But are Imran Khan and Rishi Kapoor's professional and personal lives mixing in a toxic way? Imran's going through a little bit of a rough patch right now. His Gatti Batti was a failure at the box office, and now there's buzz about his attitude rubbing a senior actor the wrong way. After giving us some very notable performances, Rishi is all set to star in a movie titled Wedding Pulao. And when he read the script, he suggested Imran's name for the lead. Well, seems Imran has become quite choosy about his movies and won't agree to do just any film because he is down on his luck. The buzz is that Imran rejected the offer aur usne to aisa bhi socha ki kya Rishi bete Ranbir ko is role ke liye suggest karte. However, Rishi and Imran both gave clarifications to various sections of the media later, putting the rumors to rest. Rishi confirmed that he had suggested Imran's name, but thought that the latter rejected the offer because of a scheduling conflict. And Imran clarified that it wasn't him but his manager who took the call and it never reached him because his schedule was conflicting with Gatti Batti. This isn't the first time Imran's had such interactions with senior industry people. 9xc.com told you about how Imran had a spat with the Ravel family when Imran passed some comments during an interview about director Rahul Ravel. In fact, Rahul was initially supposed to direct Wedding Pulao. Could Imran's refusal to do the film have anything to do with their troubled history? Imran has once again burnt his bridges with Ekta Kapoor. We hope that the two have read each other's comments and that it has cleared the air. Coming up, is Aishwarya's comeback film all it's made out to be? We review Jazba. On the Rocks couple Ranveer and Deepika kiss in public. Is it only for the cameras? Welcome back to 9xc.com the show, your one-stop shop for everything Bollywood. The moment has finally arrived. After 5 long years, Aishwarya Rai Bachchan returns to cinemas with Jazba. But is the film worth the hype and is Aishwarya's performance worth the wait? Here's our movie buff with the answers.
What's up? Mera naam hai Prabhut Daima aur maine dekhi Jazba. Now, Jazba ki kahani jo hai wo kuch aisi hai ki Aishwarya Rai wo ek play karti hai character lawyer ka aur unki beti jo hai wo kidnap ho jati hai. और रैंसम के तौर पर उन्हें क्या करना है, एक खूनी दरिंदे को कानून के चंगुल से बचाना है. तो फिल्म में कमबैक कर रही है ऐश्वर्या राय बच्चन. नाउ बॉस, शी इज बैक एंड हाउ यू कैन सी दैट कन्विक्शन इन एवरी सीन, इन एवरी शॉट, इन एवरी फ्रेम. एंड बॉस, वो नीली आंखें मरवाएंगी, मतलब मरवाएंगी मरवाएंगी. आई एम सो हैप्पी दैट शी चोज टू डू सच अ मैच्योर रोल फॉर हर कमबैक. एंड यू कैन सी कि उन्होंने बहुत मेहनत की है और ये बहुत मेहनत करने वाली है. बस मुझे देखना है कि अब आप नेक्स्ट क्या करोगे. मतलब मैं ऐसा स्टॉल में जाके सिटी बजा, मुझे आता नहीं है, मैं दोस्त को लेके जाऊंगा, वो बजाएगा मेरे लिए सिटी. और उनके साथ फिल्म में है इरफान खान, मतलब वो हमारे बॉलीवुड के इन हाउस पुलिस ऑफिसर है. पिछले हफ्ते उन्होंने एक मर्डर केस सॉल्व किया, इस हफ्ते अब वो एक किडनैपिंग केस सॉल्व कर रहे हैं. मतलब कभी हॉलीवुड कभी बॉलीवुड, छई छप छई छपाक छई, मतलब जो भी है जैसा भी है, वो आदमी जब स्क्रीन पे आता है और डायलॉग बोलता है ना, टच हो जाता है, फील आता है, फील. बॉस, पैसा वसूल. ओवरऑल अगर फिल्म की बात की जाए तो इट्स ए टिपिकल संजय गुप्ता फिल्म, जहां पर एक्शन है, ड्रामा है, गाड़ी रुकती है, झिझक झिझक दरवाजा खुलता है और बहुत सारा रोना है. मतलब बहुत सारा रोना है. हैविंग सेड दैट, सम वेरी गुड परफॉर्मेंसेस टू लुक एट एंड इट्स अ डिसेंट वॉच. सो ऑन द हॉट स्लॉट आई गिव जज्बा 3 थम्स अप. सो 3 थिंग्स आई लर्न फ्रॉम द फिल्म. नंबर 1, 100 रुपए की रिश्वत को प्रसाद कहते हैं और 2.5 करोड़ के रिश्वत को रिश्वत कहते हैं. नंबर 2, अगर एक एंग्री कॉप आपको पीट रहा है, कभी भी हॉलीवुड पिक्चर की तरह उनको यह मत कहो कि बॉस आई नो माय राइट्स. बहुत मार पड़ेगी बॉस, बहुत मार पड़ेगी. एंड नंबर 3, माय फेवरेट, जब रिश्तों पे भरोसा और मोबाइल पे नेटवर्क ना हो तो लोग गेम खेलने लगते हैं. लाइन है. तो ये थी मेरी विशेष टिप्पणी ऑन जज्बा. याद रहे, मैं मूवी क्रिटिक जरा भी नहीं हूं, मैं मूवी बफ हूं. मैं आपको मिलूंगा अगले हफ्ते और जाने से पहले आप मेरी ऐश्वर्या राय बच्चन की मिमिक्री देख के जाओ. वो सब जानता है योहान, वो सब जानता है। बाय बाय।
I think I can speak for most of us when I say that we have been so taken up with Kajol and Shahrukh Khan reuniting on screen in Dilwale that somewhere we've forgotten that there's another on-screen Jodi as well. Varun Dhawan and Kriti Sanon are also cast opposite each other in this Rohit Shetty film. And while Kajol and Shahrukh have been rediscovering their on-screen chemistry, off-screen Varun and Kriti have been showing some chemistry of their own. At Kriti Sanon feels shy when she sees me. So sweet, right guys? But itna hi nahi, Kriti ne Varun ko reply kiya, saying, Haha, yeah, my eyes couldn't take the glow on your face. Clearly these two are flirting, let alone in full public view. Par jahan tak hame pata hai, Varun ki girlfriend Natasha Dalal is very much in the picture. And Kriti is also rumored to be in a relationship with model Gaurav Arora. So can we label this harmless flirting or a publicity stunt? Because obviously Kriti and Varun tweeting each other will make news, especially when their conversations have a flirtatious undertone. So has this move been dictated to them by the film's PR machinery? Ya fir Varun aur Kriti ne khud hi decide kar liya hai to promote the film way ahead of schedule. But these two are not alone in resorting to mild flirtation to create buzz around their movie. Recently, Ranveer Singh and Deepika Padukone were spotted at Mumbai airport getting super cozy. Yep, it is them. An eyewitness told us, from the airport they went to their respective homes, but not before that Ranveer escorted Deepika to her car and the two shared a passionate kiss. Now, Nanixi.com has been telling you that all's not well between Ranveer and Deepika. Their relationship is rocky because Deepika refuses to give Ranveer what he wants, which is commitment. But it's not like the two can start arguing in public while they promote their epic love story, Bajirao Mastani. They not only have to keep up a united front, but also a lovey-dovey one. But the stars have to deal with a lot even when they're not promoting their films, like trolls on Twitter. Sonam Kapoor and Anushka Sharma are just some of these stars. However, leave it to Shah Rukh Khan to shut down the trolls like a thalaiva. For Shah Rukh, his sparring with the trolls started when Farhan Akhtar announced on Twitter that he had commenced the shooting for the sequel of Rock On. And we're off, and rolling and rocking, hashtag RockOn2, hashtag Shillong. SRK, who Farhan has directed in the Don franchise, wished him the best of luck. At Farout Akhtar, all the best, my rockstar, have a good shoot. The Twitter conversation became fodder for trolls who used highly inappropriate language for no apparent reason. Well, Shah Rukh ne bhi liya badla aur trolls ko diya muh tod jawab. This is what his Twitter account said later. On social media, you do slash say what you feel, free expression, blah blah. But will request my people not to deride or abuse other films and colleagues. Not cool. And if you thought that's how King Khan left things, sample this tweet. But your life, your rules, I'm not here to teach manners, but I deal with idiots with sarcasm. Madar Bain users are low on vocabulary and status. Well, this should be a lesson to trolls to not mess with the Badshah of Bollywood. And what they should also learn is to stay clear of Farhan. On his Facebook page, Farhan urged his followers to speak up against the lynching of a man in Dadri rumored to have eaten or stored beef in his home. A day later, on his Farhan Akhtar live page, he said that Rock On 2 was going to go on floors. To which one person commented, "Yesterday you were crying so hard for Dadri case. Your brother has killed his kid for not wearing burqa while eating. Any words, you Pakistani Akhtar?" Well, seems the user compared the Dadri incident to another one where a man killed his daughter because she forgot to cover her head when her shawl slipped. Wonder how these incidents are connected. But Farhan had a fitting reply. "Yes, I hope he rots in hell, which he will, and I hope you grow a brain, which I doubt you will. But all the best." Well, Farhan certainly put them in their place. Tell us your thoughts on the story by tweeting to us at 9XE The Show using hashtag CelebsVersusTrolls or talk to us on Facebook.com. Coming up, Aamir provides financial assistance to ailing director Kalpana Lazmi. This is how Shahid went from chocolate boy to sexy actor. And we meet again on 9XE.com, The Show. Almost everyone remembers the song Dil Hum Hum Kare from the movie Rudali, and we have director Kalpana Lazmi to thank for the immortal tune. Unfortunately, we have some very sad news for you on Kalpana's front. Kalpana has been diagnosed with a tumor in the kidney, which requires complicated and expensive medical processes like a dialysis. Bollywood stepped in during her time of need, and as soon as celebs like Aamir Khan, wife Kiran Rao, and director Rohit Shetty heard about this, they contributed generous amounts to ensure that financial constraints don't come in the way of Kalpana's treatment. Kalpana recently told a section of the media that she'd have to undergo dialysis 3 times a week till the last day of her life, and thanked Amir and Kiran's generosity for having covered the cost of the dialysis for at least 6 months. Other luminaries like filmmaker Ashok Pandit and director Vinta Nanda have also lent a helping hand to the ailing Kalpana, and efforts are on to gather more funds. Kalpana, who has given us such intense movies as Rudali and Daman, fell on hard times after the death of her longtime partner, singer Bhupen Hazarika. Bhupen died of multiple organ failure in 2011. Well, it is great to see Bollywood coming through for one of their own. And looking forward, Shahid Kapoor has come a long way since his Ishq Vishq days. He's gone from playing the romantic guy to playing a tortured soul and back to playing the romantic guy, but this time with some maturity. Through the years, as his film choices have evolved, so has his fashion. Shahid entered the industry as a baby-faced chocolate boy. He carried his on-screen sweet guy image off-screen as well and was seen in basic t-shirts and jeans. The change came somewhere around the time when Shahid was promoting Mausam. Gone were the boyish tees and jeans, he now began to dress more maturely. After all, he had turned 30. Yet, Shahid maintained this boyish charm. It has only been smooth sailing. He's brought out sharp suits, fitted shirts, cool jackets, and oodles of charm. Black seems to have become his go-to style statement, and let's not forget that along the way he's changed his status from cute and sexy and eligible bachelor to married man. Shahid's style might seem pretty straightforward, but don't be fooled. He's got a wild side too. Thanks to his friend and designer Kunal Rawal, Shahid's style has got an edge. He walked the ramp for his buddy in goth makeup and even sported an amazing jacket from Kunal's collection. Recently, Shahid got on board with the trend of man buns and undercuts. And now he has a shaggy sort of look and he's killing it with that too. He's also grown a sexy beard and we hope he never finds a razor. All you Sasha fans, tell us what you think about Shahid's evolution from boy next door to the sexy alpha male. Tweet to us at 9xctheshow using hashtag AlphaShahid or talk to us on facebook.com/9xc. And on that steamy note, it's time to wrap up this episode. I'll catch you guys on Monday now. Tab tak, check out our site 9xc.com and our YouTube channel for full episodes of the show. Find us on facebook.com/9xc and tweet to us at 9xctheshow. Download our free 9xc app for Android and iOS. And before I go, here is a 9xc Frames moment. Check out Shahid's Shandar co-star Alia Bhatt working out like a boss. Now you guys know the secret behind that gorgeous bikini body of hers. Ciao for now, guys.